Hi everyone, Luton here, and I've got a gameplay for my 24-hour event this evening. I didn't want to go with another one for my server, I wanted to pull up. I've still got like so much footage. I still have like about 14, 15 hours of footage. Not all the games are really worth putting up, some of them are, you know, just boring, some of them take too long, etc, etc. But I got plenty here, so I'll throw these up over the next month, just every now and then if I look back and there's a good round. So, as you can see, I come into this round, dropping smoke to cover myself there, and basically our tank has been taken down the road. I assume it's been destroyed by the flaming wreck down there, and our guys are basically trying to get into B. Everybody knows this is the horrible one to do so. Generally, the best thing to do on this map, if you can get the LAV, is to just quickly, you know, run in there, take a good group, get in, smoke, throw a lot of stuff, just getting clear out, just rush by force. As I was talking about before with the whole momentum video, really what you want to do is just get a strong punching force of a squad, get in there, try and clear it before they can really set up. That hasn't happened. And this, you know, this event happened a week ago. I cannot remember exactly how this goes down. I've just given this round a quick overview before I started talking, so I'm not entirely sure what goes down, so we'll have a look. I'm going with the KH-2002 again, which is one of my favourite ones. Why did I not change my pistol there? I should have, you know, tried to do that instead of reloading. I will remember that for another time. Why are you mortaring? Well, I suppose actually mortaring is a good thing to do. Mortaring is a good thing to do on this first one because clearing out the B section, smoke and mortars can be really helped. I haven't really helped plant this, but it is planted, so I'm doing my best to defend it right now. Which I'm obviously not doing a very good job. I said that right now because I was thinking, yeah, no problem. Yeah, they're not going to get this disarmed. Wow, look how many of them there are in there. Now, this is a fairly generic situation right now. A has gone down because they rarely will bother to defend it. And their entire team is on B. And I think every single person playing the game has been in this situation before. In terms of how long I've been playing by this point, I think it was a good... Seth is in and he doesn't come on till late, so I'm guessing it was around 8 hours, something like that. Probably about that. That feels about the right amount of time. And the LAV is really key in these situations. Look how much fire we're taking. I'm barely even out of my base and we're already they're pushing forward. However, the aggressiveness of a team at this point can be really key in terms of how well you actually succeed, whether you manage to defend or not. If you get too aggressive, that can be a really bad thing because you can flank by going completely around the side here. And obviously you can get trapped by C4. Or claymores or any of these things, people are going to set up and try and defend the whole situation. But you can see right now, if you look at the mini-map, look what's happening. You see there's like three or four guys leaving the B area and they're doing this, they're pushing forward. See, we've got multiple guys right here pushing forward. This is a big error, big error to make. Because that means that they're going to have at least half their force out and around B. There's no problem with having someone kind of just out in this square here, but any further forward is going to be a really bad move. It doesn't take too much to control these choke points, but the point is that if you get rushed, which is often what will happen, if you do not have enough people there to support and repel that, it may literally be a case of just having the bodies on the ground. If you don't have enough people there, then you're going to, you know, possibly lose the situation. Now, normally I would try and flank, but I decided that I would just go for, you know, straight in on this one. I thought maybe fire some guns, get thrown in. Look at Paulie here, being cocky, hollow on his SV-98. What the hell is that? So, things not looking too good right now. We look at our tickets, they're literally dropping off every second. 26, 27, blah, blah, blah. I'm curious as to what happens here. I mean, I know... I know we get this base, but I'm curious as to what goes down. You know, it's a 19-minute video. I don't think we managed to survive that long on just these tickets. Have they stolen our LAV as well? Oh my god. This is a really, really bad situation. How can we possibly take this now? How can we? They've got the LAV and they've got this completely locked down. How can we possibly take this? So I'm doing my fairly generic thing of dropping a lot of smoke. Do I get the arm? No. No would be the quite simple answer. But we have managed to breach, which I'm curious as to why they've allowed this to happen. I think just overconfidence. This is something that happens a lot. We're down on like 10 tickets, and you see often with... They've got the LAV. How can they possibly let this happen? I'm just trying to watch the minimap here. This is often what I do when I'm reviewing things, and I obviously can't see exactly what's happening. Come on, LT. Need to clear those guys out first, but we're in a much stronger position than we were. We've managed to get in here, clear this. There we go, there's the arm. This is what often will happen towards the end of a round, is the overconfidence of an enemy team will let them down. Because the weight of an attacking force can often just push in really, really crazy, trying to get in there, take it all out. And there you go, they've totally lost it. I think just helps to show that, you know, you shouldn't always assume that right at the end everything's over. I've been in so many games. Oh, there's Andy Rodge. I remember he made a comment on one of my videos saying that he was in some rounds. I'm sure he'll be pleased to see himself. That's the other reason I wanted to get some of these up, is because a lot of people played and came to support me on this evening, and they haven't had a chance to have all their videos up, so I'm trying to post some up, some more ones to get people up. And also talking about my server. Yeah, go down, Noz. talking about momentum, look, see we're already pushing forward. We want to get to these bases before they have a chance to dig in like they did on the previous ones. Oh, damn, C4 again. Yeah, I haven't been on my server this week. I've just been busy and tired and da-da-da, you know. So, but I've had a lot of people talking about my server and saying that the games are still being really good and so on. But I'm going to be on before the end of the week, so don't worry. I'll be there. The server can continue without me being there. It's not essential that I'm playing. And it seems that, by the sound of it, most people playing are all sticking kind of to the, you know, the format. People want to play good, strong games, and that's what it's being. So, yeah, I'm pleased that that's how it's going down. And there's been a lot of talk this week. I've seen a lot of, sort of articles and things. I tweeted an article today, if anyone saw that, about the fact that the whole server situation is becoming increasingly difficult, and DICE are starting to, you know, hear a lot more vocal, sort of feedback. M320. Feedback about the server situation, and I really sympathise. I think it sucks. You know, I don't understand why they've just completely lost the DICE servers. I think it's really, really irritating. And luckily, I have my own server, and I'm providing that for people, you know, to come and play, who want proper normal games, proper objective games. And it's kind of worked in my favour in a way, because it means that all the objective good players have been focused into one place, and a lot of people are coming onto my server to have those kind of games now. So yeah, I'm kind of pleased about that in a way, but it is kind of irritating that so many servers, but I think it just kind of goes to represent a lot of the time what I'm talking about, a lot of the time what I say about the kind of sad thing about the way gaming is going, which is that people want a lot of the same crappy gameplay, the same, you know, just frustrating sort of, I don't know, not objective, whoa, what's going on here? Not objective gameplay, you know, the typical kind of run spam, smart, you know, trying to be trick-shotting, blah blah blah, all this kind of silly messing around. High ticket counts because people want the points and they want the KDs and they want all this stuff. But it spoils it for people who want some proper gameplay. Also, you know, there's been a lot of talk about abusive admins and stuff like this, people who say, like, no shotguns. I saw someone today talking about it, and they're saying, like, some servers, people even saying, you know, they put a note on their server saying aircraft for admins only. So if you're not a server admin, you're not allowed to use aircraft. And if anyone does, they'll just ban and kick you immediately, which is completely ridiculous. Oh, that took you two shots there, Paulie. Two shots, I heard the first. That should have been a clean kill from that range. I'm really tired, by the way, if you can tell. I just wanted to put something together for you guys to have something to go on. I've got some other bits and pieces, like I've said. Oh, this feels very familiar, doesn't it? Where do we recognise this exact moment from? I think it's been in one of my clip sequences. Look at this scrub. Philip Clausen, you should be ashamed of yourself. Sitting in a corner with an automatic shotgun. Nah, he was doing good. He was covering the rear. But, I've got to do some other videos soon. I've got a list of things that I need to do. It's all a matter of just getting it done. I want to do some rush routes because I haven't done that for a little while. And I know which one I want to do for that. I want to do Tehran Highway. And I want to do Tehran because, as far as I can tell, people haven't got a clue how to do that. I'm rarely ever am I in a public game, unless the defenders completely suck, am I ever in a game where people play Tehran to the point where they actually handle the situation. Similarly, I have been in many defending teams who, on the complete flip side, haven't got a clue what they're doing, and they let the same mistakes happen every time. So Tehran is one that I really think needs some looking at. But the other thing I've got to do is I've got to give away this PC code. I made a video saying that I was going to give away a PC code, and I'm going to do it, but it's all a matter of finding the time. I know what I want to do for it, I've just got to set aside some time, and my schedule has been rammed this last week. I've had work and a lot of other stuff going on, things I've had to do, been out and about, so I've had a huge amount of stuff to do that has been not gaming related at all. I've got a load of projects. I'm not going to talk about it all because, like, you know, you guys know I don't do that. But and then I'm going away this next week as well, so I won't be here for the following weekend, and that's going to mean I don't have a lot of time for doing this stuff as well. So yeah, it's going to be thin on the ground for a little bit anyway. But yeah, I want to get that PC thing done because I don't want that sitting on my head. I don't want that sitting waiting too long, and I'm sure, you know, people want it, they want to give it away. So I'm going to get that done. I'm going to get that done this week, and I'm going to work on it probably tomorrow, I guess. What day is it? Tomorrow, yeah. Okay. So I can get that one sorted out, get that way, get it started. You guys can do it. Maybe I can finish by the end of the week, hopefully. So, and then people can get in the mix and get playing. But for now, okay, let's take a look at where we are in the game. So we've pushed up, and you saw that I managed to flank, and we got some guys, got to A. Now I've pushed across to B, we're taking this one. And this base, I often find, is it can be either a nightmare or fairly straightforward depending on how the team is playing. Again, as with the first bases, etc., it's just a case of flanking, smoking, putting some good positions. I have another good round of this that I think I played very recently, so I can put up another Seine crossing. Here we go, spawning in on them and randomly spraying my gun all over the place. So now we're moving on to the last one, and my big tip for the last one, okay, the base obviously that everyone has trouble with is the one in the bank itself. Everyone knows that it's a nightmare and you've been in it many times. The key to the bank, as I find it, is the small reception desk area just to the right of B itself, and you'll see what I'm talking about. We go in there. Now the reason this is the key is because I often find you'll get people camped in there with an LMG or whatever. The thing about it is that you can cover the objective from that very, very easily. And so it often will be that someone up there catches you out just when you've managed to finally get in and clear it. Now you see one of our guys is armed A. Again, really, really not ideal, because they will probably completely ignore that. I don't think they've got one person going for it, and the rest of them are staying in there. Nobody's going to go for it. You may as well leave it, really, because, to be honest, at least it gives some of the enemy team a bit of a half thought, you know, to do it. I'm just putting this back here. It's kind of out of the way there. It's a little way away, but it saves us running up the road. Really want to check to my left here. I don't know why I didn't. And people will sit at the top of those stairs. Man, this is a lot more empty than I thought. But you see back here where I put a grenade, that's really where I'm trying to focus my attention. I know I got shot in the back, but that reception desk area is the one that's often the real killer. So this round has been pretty good, really. Their main flaw was obviously losing that first base, and people know that this is one of these rounds where if you lose the first base, it can be really all over. But Seine, I quite like it as rush because it's quite open, you know, it's quite large, there's a lot of flanking routes to use. So there can be a lot of quite interesting gameplay going on with Seine. This is really not ideal. Yeah, see, I gave up. You see how I changed my route there? And the reason for that is once you've got locked down like we did to the point where they've already realized that there's multiple people there, they've got the drop on you, so you want to change your route. You don't want to... Oh, my God. You want to change your route. You don't want to go the same way, so sort of flanking around. If they've marked you, they know you're there, they're waiting for you. They've got the drop. And like we saw, there's already going to be the chance that there's multiple people, so you really don't want to sort of stay that way. So just making a quick course change is really what you want. Really piss poor aiming there. There's always one of these frantic situations. There's a guy to my right. Why did I not go for him? Anyway, so like I've said before, not one of my best games, but I wanted to put this up because I thought it was some good overall gameplay from the team, and it was just a kind of moderately fair. That first part was kind of interesting. Not the best overall gameplay for me, but you can't have everything, can you? And so we're still finishing up here. I went with the M5K here because I really like the M5K. It's a great close quarters weapon, really high fire rate, pretty accurate. You can just literally slap it into them. Now, a lot of people still prefer the MP7. I see people using that preference all the time, but I do like the M5K. It's a nice gun. I want to do some close quarters stuff as well. I want to play some games. I want to get on Battlefield. I just haven't been able to get on Battlefield this week, so yeah, it would be nice to have some gameplay, so we'll look at that soon. Anyway, guys, I'm just going to cut off here because I'm pretty much done, and we'll just allow the rest of the round to play out. Thanks for watching, and see you for another one.